Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Today is Ash Wednesday. It is the first day in the season of Lent. It is a Christian holy day of prayer. Ash Wednesday is like an open door which we choose to walk through to become closer to knowing God. It leads us through the 40 days of Lent.
Ash Wednesday marks the start of a time when we think about our actions, and we will try extra hard to make the right choices.
I'm sorry I was cross with you. Please can we be friends again?
We pray to be forgiven for the things we have done wrong. We feel sad because sometimes we forget to be kind to each other.
We especially think about how much we love God and how much He loves us.
The scripture reading for today is from Numbers chapter 23, verse 19. The Lord Himself goes before you. He will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid, do not be discouraged. Amen.
This is a world that encourages us to believe in ourselves and be the best that we can be. It is about trusting God, to know He will always keep His promises to us because He is merciful. He wants us to know Him and He wants us to open our hearts to Him.
Everyone is invited, whether they have a faith or not. The priest draws a cross on each person's head with the ashes and says, "Remember from dust you came and to dust you will return."
Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return. This means our lives are a gift from God. His love is so great and so powerful that for us it will never end.
These words about the dust were first spoken about Adam and Eve in the book of Genesis. They turned away from God when they ate from the tree of knowledge. They did something God asked them not to.
Sometimes we do things that God has asked us not to do, but we turn towards God. We mark our foreheads with ashes at the beginning of Lent to show that we recognise and feel truly sorry for the times when we have made our wrong choices.
Long, long time ago, people wore sackcloth and ashes to show that they were sorry for their sins. How scratchy and uncomfortable that must have been.
The ashes which had received are made from last year's plum leaves, which has been blessed.
Many people keep ashes in the shape of the cross on their foreheads all day as a reminder of this special day of prayer and that Christ chose to die for us all.
When you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your part. Oh, when darkness comes.
It is believed that Ash Wednesday first happened in the Middle Ages, 700 AD, it was called the Day of Ashes.
Palm leaves are a symbol of victory and triumph. They were laid before Jesus leaves and the crowd cheered.
Hosanna!
But soon the crowd turned against him. The triumph palm leaves were turned into ash, a symbol of his sentence of death.
I do love a pancake. Delicious. My favourite topping is syrup, please. But what's that got to do with Ash Wednesday?
Shrove Tuesday is the day before Ash Wednesday because in the past, people used to fast, eat very little foods. They'd make a form of pancake to use up their eggs, flour and butter before they went rotten. Today, many Christians give up certain foods during Lent.
It isn't always easy to do what is right, though. Often we are tempted to do what is wrong. Even Jesus was tempted, but he did not give in. Once Jesus spent 40 days in the desert, he ate nothing and so he felt very weak. Then the devil came to him, and he said he would give Jesus food, kingdoms and power if Jesus worshipped him. But Jesus, with God's help, found the strength to say no. He made the right choice.
God the Father helped Jesus to be strong. He'll help us as well. Let us ask him to do so. The response after each line is, Father, make us strong.
Tempted to do what is wrong when we do not get what we want, when we are afraid of doing new things, when we want to be kind and thoughtful, when we want to make new friends, when we want to say sorry.
If the best choice is difficult or unpleasant, give us the courage to make it. Amen.
When Jesus was tempted in the desert, he knew he had to make the right choices. Today, even though we may not be able to receive the ashes due to our safety, let us decide to try very hard to make the right choices today. God knows what's in our hearts.
Lent is a time to change, to become a better version of ourselves and to become more like Jesus. The ashes we receive on Ash Wednesday remind us of our call to be humble, be willing to make a change and believe in the gospel.
For all the things that I do that I know I shouldn't, I'm sorry.